I've heard people say, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. People have always been telling me, man, Chris, you say everything the wrong way. You know, you have a very, very, very hard time delivering your message, man. You're not doing it right. You should be better at it. You should do it another way. You should do it the way that we say you should do it, and then we think you'd be better at it, and it would be more successful, and people would actually listen to you, right? They tell me that if I change how I say things, that I'll actually get my point across. And I think to myself, that sounds very good. I enjoy that thought very much with you. I'm right there. But part of the reason that I'm in this position in the first place is because I'm a ferocious critical thinker, and I'm critical of everything. As I will prove later on tonight, I'm going to prove to you that science does not exist. How? What? This is crazy, impossible. Stay tuned, it's coming later. But for now, we're concentrating on not what I'm saying, but how I'm saying it. Is this way better for you? Does it help my message get across? Have I said anything yet? These are all to be examined. Now, there's a part of a book where there's this guy, and he's doing the same thing I'm doing. He's doing a Socratic Methodist attack. Spiritual Kamehameha on the society. He's shaking things up, raising hell, just speaking from his own authority, not citing anyone else, not asking for anyone's permission or help. And he doesn't own anything, and he doesn't have any credentials necessarily that entitle him to this, you know, reality. That's what people are always saying to me, man. Where did you get that badge? Oh, from a supermarket. Dr. Rockwell. Oh, yeah. You gave this name to yourself, huh, guy? No, I didn't. You want to know something? People have been calling me Dr. Rockwell since I was 9 years old. What am I supposed to do? It's a nickname that follows me around, like Rockhead and King Bullshit. I think I can't do anything about this. I'm a fucking firecracker. My brain is on fire. Can't you see this? And I have Tai Chi on my mind all the time. I tear through information and concepts like a freaking hydra on steroids, smoking crack and speed reading at the same time. One head in total tantric meditation on universal everything. I have no idea what it's like to be inside this brain and know why I have to, you know, do what I'm doing. This is the heaviest shit in the world, man. So I'm trying to express it to you, but, you know, if it's coming across too heavy, man, like, relax. I'm just a drunkard and a glutton. You wouldn't listen to me if I was a starving ascetic. You know what I'm saying? And that it's not. Oh, excuse me. I smoke a lot too. But at any rate, what I'm trying to say is, if you took all these faults in me, and you said all these things about me that are bad, hey man, you're not giving a good message, man. Because you don't say it the right way. You swear too much, and your camera sucks, and the sound is wonky all the time, and you use crazy language and weird accents, and you're always jumping around and gesticulating, and you're blurry and we can't see you, and you should make it better or else we're not gonna listen. Noted. I got it. I understand. Okay, here's what I'm saying. All right, the other day I'm out at the park enjoying myself with the Olympians have come to be the gods and goddesses living in paradise in Sebastopol, taking it onto themselves to save the world with their newfangled culture. So we're all out there playing volleyball, and I'm taking a break because I've already played like 6 games, and other people are showing up, and they're having to sit out while I'm playing more. So I think to myself, you know what I'm saying? I've had a lot of sun. I need some shade. I'm gonna go over there and smoke and eat some chips and drink some iced tea and talk to my friends. And so these people I don't even know, but they're cool, you know, whatever. All right, so I go over there and I sit down and we start talking, and these kids come by and they're like, "Hey, yeah, we just went to the Floyd show in San Francisco and it was awesome, man. Except it sucked because it was too negative. It was the wall. We don't like the wall." And that struck a nerve, you know, a chord in me, because the wall is my favorite Floyd album, of course, you know. Like, what do you think it would be? Metal? You know? Dark Side of the Moon? Money? No. It's Comfortably Numb, baby. Yeah, I know what we're talking about here. So, as this chick's leaving, and she's like, "Hey, yeah, it was too negative for me. I don't like, you know, any bad, hurtful, painful thoughts at all, because I don't know how to deal with them. And I just want the world to be one big orgy of happiness and gluttony all the time. And that would be better. And so, bye." And as she's leaving, I'm like, "Yeah, I have another fucking pineapple." And somebody's like, "What? You know, what are you talking about? Another pineapple?" And I'm like, "Oh, I'm just talking about, you know, people living in paradise with all their entitlements, you know, you know, everything they have. They go see the Floyd show in Frisco and, you know, wake up every morning and have their coffee and their banana and extra sugar, and, you know, they get to have pineapple whenever they want because it's always available to them. And they don't even know where these things come from or how they got them. They have no clue what the relationships in the world are, even though those things aren't hidden. They're, you know, very, very well known. They're well established. There's, you know, no denying neo-colonialist reality or history or, you know, the reason why you have pineapples and bananas and coffee and sugar and other people are living in shanty towns feeding their kids fucking mud rock weed soup." And so I'm saying all of this to these people, and I'm not being very nice about it. Can you imagine that? I'm not being nice by sparing these folks' feelings that everything that they have, right down to the volleyball courts they're on, is stolen from other people through a fucking Masonic language Kabbalism kin-a-kang-kang-kang-kang gang that runs the entire freaking economy, money system, military, politics, and everything else from the top down. And it's not a conspiracy, it's a final result. It's an effect that you experience upon your world. It's the reason that you don't have any say in anything. And you talk about people getting freedoms in places like Egypt and stuff like that, and then when people come out and want to protest the government here, they get punched in the face. Okay? Like, so I'm just calling it how I see it, and it's not very pretty. And, you know, so I'm not using great language, you know, I'm not being real nice about it. Oh, excuse me. I'm gonna have to take a drink. And I think that's the point. It kind of gets stuck in your throat. It's unpleasant. It doesn't feel good. It doesn't feel good coming out, and it doesn't feel good landing on your ear. And people aren't going to listen because they're not going to stop. They would rather have their bananas and their coffee and their sugar and their pineapples and their volleyball courts. And it doesn't matter if they have to cut down trees and displace poor, less fortunate people. It doesn't matter if their entire system is built off of genocide and murder and slavery and theft and lies and bullshit. It doesn't matter if that system is going to come back in the end to bite those people in their very asses and burn everything they have down and lock them up and torture them and put them through hell. You know, it doesn't matter if they're gonna, you know, slave their entire lives away for things that they don't understand in a meaningless vortex of consumeristic bullshit. You know, none of that matters, you know, because we'll just be positive about it and just have more. You know, have more, have more, constantly, more, 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 more. People don't care, man. They don't care if you say it nice. They're not gonna stop. They're not gonna change. It doesn't matter what you say. It doesn't matter how you say it. People have to be motivated. They have to feel it. They have to experience it for themselves. People have to become willing to make those changes on their own. And until a critical mass of people makes those changes in a lot of different areas, you know, the culture's not going to change. People aren't going to change. We're not evolving into some higher state of consciousness because people are, you know, everything is one, man, and one is love. You just reduce the entire chaotic, fucking infinite experience in front of you to a single, piddly, like, static. Unless you can kabbalistically unlock that and expand it back into nothing is everything and everything is nothing and the nexus in between the two is the flexor that gives you all other reality. Unless you can understand Tai Chi and you can express it and you can see it everywhere in the world around you and use it and make it work for you, you got nothing. You haven't had any evolution. You haven't experienced Krishnamurti's revolution of mind. You're not capable of critical thinking. You're not capable of any willpower or amplitude to change your life should you notice that there's a reason you should. You know, so that's what you do. You say, hey man, you know, I would listen to you, but you're just an asshole. And I like coffee and sugar and bananas and pineapples and volleyball courts that were stolen from Native American people. And I'm gonna tell everybody, hey, free Tibet. Because fuck those Chinamen over there, right? They can't steal countries. We're the only ones who get to do that, right? The Dutch have to give up their colonies, the Spanish, everybody else, the Portuguese, all those guys have to give up their colonies. Well, we keep ours. And the Brits can keep half theirs. Your whole system's built on lies. It doesn't matter what you say, and it doesn't matter how you say it. The truth's gonna hurt, and it's not gonna be pretty. That's the way it is. That's the way it always has been, and that's the way it's gonna be. And until you people saddle up to that, there ain't gonna be no evolution, revolution, ain't gonna be no loving. So get on board, people. This is it. It's ugly, and it ain't going anywhere. If you don't like it, tune it out and have another pineapple.